The Space Shuttle Columbia disaster was a fatal incident in the United States space program that occurred on February 1, 2003, when the Space Shuttle Columbia disintegrated as it re-entered the atmosphere, killing all seven crew members. During the launch of STS-107, Columbia's 28th mission, a piece of foam insulation broke off from the Space Shuttle external tank and struck the left wing of the orbiter. Details of the DoD's unfulfilled participation with Columbia remain secret, retired NASA official Wayne Hale stated in 2012 that activity regarding other national assets and agencies remains classified and I cannot comment on that aspect of the Columbia tragedy. 8:55, nearly 11 minutes after Columbia re-entered the atmosphere, wing leading edge temperatures normally reached nearly 3,000 degrees Fahrenheit. 8:55 and 32 seconds, Columbia crossed from Nevada into Utah. At 14:04 EST, President George W. Bush said, "My fellow Americans, this day has brought terrible news and great sadness to our country." At 9 o'clock this morning, Mission Control in Houston lost contact with our Space Shuttle Columbia. A short time later, debris was seen falling from the skies above Texas. "The Columbia is lost, there are no survivors." Despite the disaster, Bush said, "The cause in which they died will continue, our journey into space will go on." Bush later declared East Texas a federal disaster area, allowing federal agencies to help with the recovery effort. According to Mike Cunilli, project manager of the Columbia Research and Preservation Office, the searchers put their life on hold to help out the nation's space program, showing what space means to people. NASA issued warnings to the public that any debris could contain hazardous chemicals, that it should be left untouched, its location reported to local emergency services or government authorities, and that anyone in unauthorized possession of debris would be prosecuted. All recovered non-human Columbia debris is stored in unused office space at the Vehicle Assembly Building, except for parts of the crew compartment, which are kept separate. As Mission Control could deorbit an empty shuttle, but could not control the orbiter's re-entry and landing, it is likely that it would have sent Columbia into the Pacific Ocean. NASA later developed the Remote Control Orbiter System to permit Mission Control to land a shuttle. On February 2, 2003, and throughout March, April, and May 2003, large memorial Catholic Brazilian masses and Roman Catholic memorial concerts were held in Rio de Janeiro, São Paulo, and other cities in Brazil where Brazilian Catholic priest Marcelo Rossi and his concert partner Belo sang a Christian hymnoides Trias ou Eras as tribute to the seven Columbia astronauts, as well as the other seven crew members who lost their lives in the Space Shuttle Challenger disaster in 1986. On February 1, 2004, the first anniversary of the Columbia disaster, Super Bowl 38 held in Houston's Reliant Stadium began with a pre-game tribute to the crew of the Columbia by singer Josh Groban performing You Raise Me Up, with the crew of STS-114, the first post-Columbia space shuttle mission, in attendance. In 2004, Bush conferred posthumous Congressional Space Medals of Honor to all 14 crew members lost in the Challenger and Columbia accidents. On Mars, the landing site of the rover Spirit was named Columbia Memorial Station, and included a memorial plaque to the Columbia crew mounted on the back of the high-gain antenna. Seven dormitories were named in honor of Columbia crew members at the Florida Institute of Technology, Creighton University, the University of Texas at Arlington, and the Columbia Elementary School in the Brevard County School District. In October 2004, both houses of Congress passed a resolution authored by U.S. Representative Lucille Roy Bulalit and co-sponsored by the entire contingent of California representatives to Congress, changing the name of Downey, California's Space Science Learning Center, to the Columbia Memorial Space Science Learning Center. PS 58 in Staten Island, New York, was named Space Shuttle Columbia School in honor of the failed mission. The Challenger Columbia Stadium in League City, Texas, is named in honor of the victims of both the Columbia disaster as well as the Challenger disaster in 1986. A starship on Star Trek, Enterprise, was named NX-02 Columbia in honor of the Columbia. A photo tribute commemorating the Columbia and its crew is displayed in the Wings of Fame section of the queue for Soarin' Around the World at Disney California Adventure Park alongside many other famous air and spacecraft. The Columbia Memorial Space Center is a museum built in honor of the Columbia in Downey, California. In March 2003, the school board of the Valverde Unified School District in California named a new school in honor of the Space Shuttle Columbia and its 7 crew members. The Columbia Crew Survival Investigation Report released by NASA on December 30, 2008, made further recommendations to improve a crew's survival chances on future space vehicles, such as the then-planned Orion spacecraft. The United States ended its space shuttle program in 2011 in part due to the fallout from the Columbia disaster. In a hoax inspired by the destruction of Columbia, some images that were purported to be satellite photographs of the shuttle's explosion turned out to be screen captures from the space shuttle destruction scene of Armageddon. The 2008 album Columbia, We Dare to Dream by Ann Cabrera was written as a tribute to Space Shuttle Columbia STS-107, the crew, support teams, recovery teams, and the crew's families.